You feel like you're missing the mark lately? Perhaps it's time to focus on... Hey, I'm Matt. You know, I don't get to break out my soccer gear very often. I don't play. In fact, the only time I ever played was when I was a little kid. And the whole year, our team scored one goal. One. The whole year, and it wasn't me. But I do have the shirt and the scarf, and check it out. Even got the last name on the back. Yeah, that's right, it's official. But I wanna talk today about goals. I wanna drive home the importance of them when it comes to your YouTube or television career. If you wanna grow your YouTube channel or you wanna advance your career in television, then you need to be making short and long-term goals, and they need to be obtainable. Also need to be a little difficult. They need to put you out of your comfort zone from time to time, drive you to be better. Now you need to celebrate the little wins, but you also need to be willing to pivot if you're over or underperforming. You do these things, positive stuff will start to happen for you. Now when I started my career in television, I thought I'm gonna be a cameraman at the network level. And I got pretty good at it early on in my career. I started getting other stations, bigger markets looking at me. But you know, life happens. I met my wife, we started a family, and I became very happy where I was at. So I pivoted. I started making new goals for my career. The thought of moving around the country from job to job wasn't as appealing anymore. So at that point, I knew if I wanted to make more money, I needed to become a news anchor. And that was my long-term goal. And guess what? I made it. It took a long time, but here I am now anchoring two different regional shows, exposed to really millions of people each and every day. And you know what? I'm happy. Now let's talk about YouTube. My initial goal, get 100 subscribers. Well, I got that pretty quick. So obviously my long-term goal at that point was I want to get monetized. And you know what? To get there though, I had to set little mini goals along the way. Let me explain. So when I hit 100, I set a time frame to hit 200, then 300, 500, etc. Now I know when I want to reach 1,000, and it's not that far away. You see, setting these benchmarks, these goals, help make you work harder. They keep you driven and focused. You know, it really gives you something to strive for. When you reach a goal on time, celebrate it, document it, share it with your friends. Go out, get yourself some ice cream, whatever makes you happy, but be proud of that. But then set yourself another goal with a time frame and get back to work. Journalists, you're likely going to start your career in some small market far away from home. So what's your goal? Is it to work in the market that's closest to home? Is it to go to the top, to the network level? Is there a particular city you've always wanted to live in? Maybe that's your long-term goal. But set that goal, give yourself X amount of time, and then start focusing in on the smaller goals. Do you want to win a wall full of awards? Do you want to change somebody's life for the better with one of your stories? Do you want to bring a criminal to justice with your reporting? I can't say this enough about goals. They keep you focused. They keep you driven. Set them, make them challenging but obtainable. Celebrate when you hit them, and be ready to pivot when necessary. My goal is that this video has helped you in some way. And if it has, please consider subscribing to Rants with Rogers and Media Authority. Be sure to hit the like button and check out the description section down below. Also, turn that notification bell to all and be sure to leave a comment. Let me know what your goal is. Who knows? Maybe I can help you reach it. And while you're at it, check out my video about storytelling. And if you need some comedic relief, watch this video and I'll see you there.